Hi, everybody. This is Allan Wright. I know many of you who are listening to this, but not all of you. And I know this will get passed around a bit and we'll send it out. So I do want to introduce myself. I co-founded the Wine Media Conference back in 2008 with Joel Vincent, who's no longer in this industry. And we've been running it ever since. My company is Zephyr Conferences. We run 5 conferences a year, 2 beer, 2 wine, and 1 food, although that's in flux. And I also have the tour side, a tour side of my business, which is an adventure travel company called Zephyr Adventures, which has been in action for 25 years, a food, wine, and beer tour company, and a company called Travel Montana that's our inbound tours to our home state of Montana. But today, as all of you know, we're talking about the Wine Media Conference, and I wanted to take the opportunity to update all of you about it and to preview what's going to happen this year in Italy, which will be exciting. So a couple of housekeeping items before we get going. I'm shooting for 30 minutes, really. We don't want to make this too long. We know everyone's busy. There will be a Q&A at the end. So if you have questions, please click on the Ask a Question button in the bottom center, the text, rather than putting it in the scrolling comment box. Feel free to put lots of stuff in the scrolling comment box. I won't be reading it. So if you have questions for me or for Giovanna, put it in the Ask a Question area. And, you know, one thought, too, is that we will send you a link to this video at the end. And it would be very helpful for us if you share this link with your wine writing friends so we can generate some enthusiasm and excitement for this conference. If all of you were to do that, you'd do a lot better job at it than we can. So that would be much appreciated. So a quick update on the Wine Media Conference. As all of you know, it was founded as the Wine Bloggers Conference in 2008. But we changed it to the Wine Media Conference to be more inclusive, really, to include not only bloggers who are a big part of us still, but also wine writers who are not blogging and also wine influencers who might not be writing in the long form as much. And that could include podcasters or videographers. You all know we did not hold the conference in 2020. It was set up. It was scheduled for August of 2020 in Eugene. But because of the pandemic, we did not hold it. We canceled all of our conferences post-pandemic start, and we ended up losing 2 of our employees, Reno and Sarah. Reno did all of our sponsorships, and Sarah did all of our logistics and operations of the conference, Sarah Pletcher. Luckily, we still have kept Sarah, the other Sarah who does our marketing, Sarah Wollner, and she's still with us. However, that does mean we're down from 4 to 2 of us working on the conferences, and it's been rough. It was a struggle to keep even Sarah on board, because all of you know that conferences were not very popular activities during the pandemic. We have decided to adjust because of that. We are no longer running the Wine Marketing and Tourism Conference and the Beer Marketing Tourism Conference. Those are 2 industry conferences. The industry folks have, frankly, a little less need to go to conferences, and many businesses just nixed travel. And so we're not running those. We are running our 3 media conferences, beer, wine, and food, this year. The good news in the pandemic really was that in 2021, we were able to run the Wine Media Conference. Many of you were there with us in Eugene. We had 144 attendees, and it worked pretty well given the pandemic. And so I think the Wine Media Conference is still going strong, and that this announcement for being in Italy will be part of that. The COVID safety is a huge issue, and I do want to address that. We had great success with this in 2021. I will say that I have taken this COVID and the pandemic extremely seriously from the very beginning. Partly my personality, partly I have an uncle who is an infectious diseases scientist, and partly it's the ethics that no matter what you think yourself about COVID, you can't really put other people in jeopardy and do it ethically. And so we have been very conservative with our practices during COVID. And in 2020, essentially we canceled almost everything. However, in 2021, things boomed again in the travel world. We ended up hosting 511 attendees last year in two conferences and in 32 tours. So it was, you know, it was a good recovery. We eventually had three people who contracted COVID and all that we knew about, and we did ask related to our tours and conferences. One was somebody who got COVID because they were testing prior to going on a tour, found out they had COVID even though they had no symptoms and stayed home. A second person tested COVID on a tour, but did not infect anybody else while on the tour, and probably got it while she was in the tour area prior to the tour starting. And then we had somebody, you many of you know, who got COVID either right before or during the Wine Media Conference last August. However, we had policies in place, including everybody there was vaccinated. And because of that, nobody else got it. And we asked multiple times. So, you know, that's a success, really. It means that we don't know of any community transmission among our own travel bubble. And it means that our policies are working, right? And so we're requiring everyone to be vaccinated or tested. In Italy, this essentially means that you have to be vaccinated and boosted, because you're not going to want to go over to Italy and expect to be doing things and going into restaurants and wineries where you're going to have the equivalent of a green card, and try and do it without being vaccinated by having a PCR test done every couple of days. So that means you can expect that everybody going to this conference is going to be vaccinated and boosted. It also means that almost everybody on the flights, if not everybody on your flight over, will be vaccinated and boosted. And so you will be in essentially a travel bubble, and it will be bigger than your normal safety bubble at home. But it works. It was proven to work last year. The masking will be optional. Right now in Italy, they're still under restrictions. It's affecting us. It's affecting the size of the conference. And we don't know where we're going to be, right? We all know, you all know, you're all paying attention to this just like everybody else, that we're seeing signs of growth, the next bubble. It doesn't really matter unless something dramatic happens. This conference is going on, and we will adjust and take it seriously and be safe. So I did want to address that. So let's move on, talk about 2022. It will be September 29 through October 1st in the Lake Garda region in Lombardy, what they call Lombardia, Italy. You can refer to our introduction announcement blog post for details about that. You also can refer to a blog post I put up this morning about our host city, which is Desenzano del Garda. It's a small little tourism area. It's on the water. Our hotel is across the street from the water. Desenzano has some great little things like a port, an old town. It's got a castle right in the middle of it. It has a walking promenade that's 2 miles long that runs from our hotel all the way along the waters of the lake to the main central historic area. So you can easily get up in the morning and go for a 4 mile walk or jog and get some exercise while you're at the same time seeing an awesome area of Italy. It's right next to a sort of its sister city of Sirmione, which is a beautiful peninsula you see that juts into the lake with a ancient town on it and a castle. And it's easy to actually take a ferry from where we will be, Desenzano, over to Sirmione, or you can take a taxi as well. So, you know, it's a beautiful area, and we'll hear more about that from Giovanna. But I did want to say that this is going to be exciting to be in Italy, right? All of you are excited, I'm sure. You wouldn't be listening to this. We're excited too. It will be a much smaller size than normal. Right now, we are limited due to COVID precautions to 64 people in the ballroom where this conference will be. That's everybody. That includes Giovanna, Sarah, and me. That includes our speakers and a few of the sponsors. But we still will have room for at least 50 riders. I think this is going to be amazing. It will be more, from my perspective as a tour operator, this is going to be kind of like a combination of conference and tour. And I can tell you that our tours are super fun. The conferences are fun. The tours are super fun. So I'm expecting this to be really great for that reason. You know, let me just give you a couple of thoughts on that. Our tours are different because we're able to bond as a group much, much, much better than we are in the conferences for the obvious reason of size, right? And so this will be the opportunity to meet all the other people in the conference and get to know them and make relationships with them, which is also important in our regular conferences, but much easier to do now that the event will be smaller. It's possible COVID regulations will change and we'll be able to increase the size. I still think, I can't remember, it might be 120 max that we would be able to do. But it's going to be smaller than normal no matter what. It's a bummer that we can't have everybody go, but we do know from Australia that not everybody's going anyway when we go abroad. And it's the perfect event to run this year as sort of another bridge year while we're still in the pandemic before we very likely would bring it back to the US and have it expand again next year. So, we do have a new policy in how we're signing up too, which is that we're asking only qualified wine media writers and influencers to be signing up now through March 31st. So we're giving those folks, you folks, first shot at that. You have to have had at least 3 posts from on your blog over the last, I think the policy is 6 months. That's not a lot. It's hardly being active. But if you're not doing that, well, then you aren't active. And frankly, the people that are sponsoring the conference and hosting the conference are disappointed to be doing that for writers who are not actually writing. So this is important. You have the ability to become active by writing posts on your blog. But if you're not, then the conference this year is probably not for you. That does mean, as I mentioned, we could use your help contacting the active wine writers that you know and encouraging them to consider going, because this will be so different. You know, it might be something that appeals to those folks who haven't been coming to the wine media conference or haven't come recently. So any help you can do in spreading the word to your friends who you know are active, involved writers would be great. Another change that's happening is that we have a meal plan. This is a mandatory meal plan. It's a $200 package, and it includes a reception, 2 lunches, and 2 dinners. This was done for multiple reasons. One is that our local contacts told us that the local restaurants in Desenzano would not be able to handle even 64 people who all left the ballroom at the same time and went out to try and get lunch. They're just not prepared for that during COVID. And so they wanted this to be the policy. Another reason is that it's hard for us to find sponsors who are ready to pay for a meal service at a hotel so that they can pour their wines for all of you. And so this enables us to give you a better experience. You who were there in Eugene know that we had a tough time with this last year. And there were some instances where even where we found sponsors to provide meals, the meals were not that amazing. Now we'll be able to provide you with better experiences. And I think it's going to make for a more rewarding conference. And why not? You're going to Italy. You don't want to skimp on the meals anyway, right? There will be some upcoming information items. Right now, the registration is open. Many of you have registered. We have not given you a lot of information. You know where the hotel is. It's the Aquavita in Desenzano, but we don't have a registration link open. I think that opens April 1, if I remember correctly. We haven't started the content speakers search. We will do that in a few weeks, probably. We haven't quite set the pre-conference and post-conference excursions. You'll hear from Giovanna, who's the head of the Ascovilla organization in Lombardia, about this a little bit, but the answer is we don't know yet because we've just finalized all the details and she has to go out to all the members and invite them to participate. That's going to take a little bit of time. What we do know is they're going to happen. So what I would suggest is planning for something to be happening both before and after, whether it's one day or 2 days each before and after, we're not quite sure yet. I would suggest not booking your airfares. Give us another month or so. We'll probably have better information. I mentioned Ascovilla. That is our partner. It's a consortium of 13 different regional wine organizations in the province, which means it's the big player, and they are our main partner. They got help with funding to help bring us there. But basically, that's our main organization, and it's a good one to have as a big partner because they are the major player in that region. The 13 organizations that make up Ascovilla operate relatively independently, but they're all part of the organization, and so we have the top of the information flow to get out to them. They will be hosting, for sure, Live Wine Social and one of the dinners. And we've been fortunate enough to work with the president of Ascovilla, who is also the owner of the Perla del Garda winery, and that is Giovanna Prandini. And we're going to have Giovanna come up now and tell us a little bit about what's going on there and about her organization. But first, as she's coming up, Sarah's going to play a quick video that Giovanna gave us to give you a sense of the region that we're going to be visiting. All right. Giovanna, you are muted. I don't know if you've, if Sarah has you muted or if you're muted, but
can you hear
are you still muted? We can hear you now. Great. Welcome, Giovanna.
Ciao. Buongiorno a tutti. Hello.
Buongiorno. Giovanna, tell us about yourself and your role as the owner of Perla del Garda Winery first, before we get into Ascovilla.
Oh, thank you, Allan. I am a wine producer I am very close to the Lake Garda, and Perla del Garda is based in Lonato del Garda, that is a small village in the southern part of the Lake Garda. And we are very close to Desenzano, where the conference will be. And we are a family company, so we are very keen on quality wines. We try to pay a lot of attention to the production. So we don't buy grapes, we don't buy wines. We try to do our best. So
excellent.
This is my...
How long has your family been in the wine business?
We used to sell the grapes until 2005, and I have started my first production in 2006. It was me and my brother who found the winery, because we were looking for something that was very personal and try to give our style and desire to express, you know, the soul of this part of the Lake Garda, very particular because we are on the hills, so we are not in the plain area, and we think we could express it in the wines in an interesting way.
Excellent. But your role with us has not been from your winery, but as the president of Ascovillo, correct? Is that a volunteer job that you do?
Yes, I do. I mean, I am very happy to try to find, you know, a way to communicate better and together what is the potential of Lombardy region, because we are recognized as the first agricultural region in Italy. But we are not very good in the communication of this big treasure when we go abroad. And sometimes single companies do their job, but it's more difficult for us to present the region with the potential we could express in wines, but not only in wines. So Ascovillo is the association of 13 consortia of wines, and it's the unique and most important association in the area. And we are trying since last March to work together in order to present the small productions and the big productions in all the potential we could have working on quality in Lombardy. So, as you know, the 13 consortia are different in size because we have a very big consortium like Oltre Po Pavese and very, very small consortium like Moscato di Scanzo. So the invitation we want to present is to come to Lake Garda, that is one of the most beautiful places in Italy, in order to discover the four denominations we have very close to the lake, but take advantage of the opportunity to visit all the production of Lombardy, the well-known like Tellina, but at the same time also the new denomination like Terre Lariane, for example, o Valcamonica, that is a new IGP in the province of Brescia on the mountains. So very different landscapes, very different climatic situations. Our aim is to present you what Lombardy could express in wines.
And just to clarify, it'll be the same way that we've always done it, which is that we'll have our 2 days of conference and we'll have wineries come into the conference center. And so we might be tasting wines from all over during those days, but then we'll also have the pre-conference and post-conference excursions. And that's what you're referencing might go out into these other areas of the province, correct?
Yes, yes. We will be very open to present several programs. Of course, Lugana area that is very close to the hotel, and the Valtenesi DOP as well, that is a vinification in pink, very interesting, and the Garda DOP, that is a production in the province of Brescia, Verona and Mantova, very close to the site, and of course the province of Mantua, where we have Lambrusco and also a very small production of interesting quality, not so well known. So we will start moving around the Acqua Viva Hotel, and we will go a little bit further in order to express all the potential of the wines of Valtellina, of Oltrepò, of the province of Bergamo, of course, with Valcaleppio and Moscato di Scanzo. And Brescia as well is very rich of potential excursions. For example, Montenetto is a very interesting area for the red wines and is based in the Capriano del Colle. And in the last 20 years, they have done a very good job. So we have a very, very interesting areas you could visit before and after the conference.
Excellent. And then during the conference, I mentioned Desenzano a little bit with the port and the old town and the castle and the promenade along the water. Your winery is 10 minutes from there. So what's your impression of Desenzano as a small city?
I mean, I am very happy about the decision to base the conference over there because it's a very beautiful area. So you can have a walk, you can be in one of the most beautiful places in Italy. The hotel will be between Desenzano and Sirmione. So Desenzano is a little bit bigger than Sirmione. Both have castles and very interesting points of interest from the artistic point of view. But we are as well in the region of fashion, of the very high quality gastronomy. So we could really enjoy also in combining food and wine and try to understand what is the most interesting combination.
Excellent. Somebody asked a question, Giovanna, and I addressed it a little bit, which is about getting to the area. Milano is clearly the airport to fly into, correct? Is that what airport you use all the time yourself?
Yeah, we are very lucky because we are between Milan, Bergamo, and Verona. So there are several opportunities to join us by plane, of course, by US, but also by train, if you want to move around in Italy and get the opportunity to visit other regions. So we will try to present you all the opportunities in order to give you the best choice.
Yeah. And Brianna asked the name of the airport. It's Milan in English. Milan is definitely the airport you will fly into from the United States. There are direct flights to get to Milan, and you won't find as easy flights getting into anywhere else in that northern area. You can take a train directly from the Milan airport into the Milan city center and directly from the city center to the city where we're located, right? So there is a train station right there that's called Desenzano Sirmione. It's the combination of the two. So that is definitely the way to go about it. And Giovanna, you mentioned a little bit about getting around. We go to Italy all the time, and I'm a big believer of the trains when you're going from city to city. It's super easy. You don't want to get in the city and drive and park and all that. If you want to go see the wine regions, you have to have a car to get to the wineries. And driving in Italy is not that big of a deal once you get used to it. So that's my suggestion for anybody that wants to spend time on their own, is if you want to go to bigger cities, you just stick with the train. If you want to go to the smaller areas or the wine regions, then you do need to rent a car. And we've got the name of the airport. So Reggie also asked a little bit about the timing, and the answer is we don't have an answer for the timing yet. What we do know is that the conference will start on Thursday afternoon and will end on Saturday evening. There won't be any part of the conference itself scheduled on Thursday morning or Wednesday or Sunday. Those are the days that we're hoping to do the pre-con and post-con. It'll probably be similar to Australia, with the difference that in Australia, when we did it there, we had to move farther distances to get to some of the wine regions. And so those had to be overnight trips. They don't have to be overnight trips in Lombardy. And so we don't know yet whether there'll be one day trips, like for example, just the Sunday, or whether we'll have an overnight trip, in which case somebody will be picking up the group from Desenzano, take us, for example, to another region, stay overnight in a hotel, and then finish up the following morning. My suggestion is not to book the flights yet. We don't book our flights this far in advance for things like this because it's too up in the air, really. But in terms of planning, if you needed to, if you planned to have 2 days before and 2 days after as part of your trip, that would be safe. And the good news is you can always go to these other cities like Bergamo and enjoy yourself as a tourist, even if you're not doing anything related to the conference. Giovanna, do you have anything else to add to everybody out there?
I have so many things to say, but the most important is the fact that we are very, very happy to welcome you to Lombardy. I think it would be a great experience because in my region we are mainly family companies, so there are so many interesting stories to know, to wineries to explore. I think it is a very big opportunity, and I will try with my friends of Ascovilo to present what is really interesting. So something that is not so common to taste around, for example, old vintages, very vertical tasting, in order to give you a lot of things to write about us. And this is very important to present the potential that as Italian we know, but we have to start with your help to communicate world around in a better way. So this is my most important aim I really think that with your help, Allan, we can stand it.
Yeah, I'm confident it's going to be a good experience for everybody. And those people who can make it are going to have an amazing time. So, Giovanna, thank you very much for spending some time with us now. Thank you for your involvement to help. You were really the one who made this whole thing happen and brought us over there. We appreciate that.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for listening. And please share the video and convince your friends to sign up now. It's all for the Qualified Wine Media now through March 31st. So now's your opportunity. Thanks, everyone.